Computer. Okay, great.
Thank you.
Welcome, guys. Welcome to our 10:30 Master Agency call. I am officially Miss Jordan Gillum because I finally got my name changed at the Social Security office like an adult. So be ready for all the email changes and all the fun stuff if you're in my organization. I am an agency owner with my wonderful husband, Jared Gillum. We are out of East Tennessee, right outside of Knoxville, and we're direct to the awesome Chris Cook. And I have been asked to host today's Master Agency Call. As you can tell, when I am given the responsibility of some form of leadership, I try to make sure I provide what level of professionalism I bring to the table. Me and Miss Tina this morning, we're going to be covering some leaderboards, some Tina's tips, and then we're just going to dive into today's topic, which I hope you guys are ready, pen and paper handy, because we are going to be learning from someone who is performing at a ridiculously high caliber when a lot of people are taking off for the holidays. So I'm really excited for today's call. Thank you guys for showing up on time. So first and foremost, guys, let's dive into some leaderboards. Today's leaderboards are nothing short of absolutely incredible. I just think it's funny how second place looks for the week, because there were some huge performers this week. I'm just insanely impressed with you guys. So we're going to start with APV leaderboards. So we're going to start with number six, which is my good friend, Amy Ostrom. I'm so proud of you, my dear, with 3,164 APV the week before Christmas. DJ Robinson out of, I think he's in California, working all over the United States from home, which is the beauty of what we have here. 3,657 APV, getting beat out by number four, Rocco Pearson, my friend. Where are you, Rocco? Great job. Great job. New agent Rocco Pearson, 3,683 APV. Number three, guys, now we're in the top three, is Scott Emmer. Listen to this week from a newbie, guys. 6,115 APV the week before Christmas. I can't get enough of that. Now, the top two is absolutely some of the most ridiculous stuff I've seen. Like, our organizations, our key leaders, our agency owners, we're striving to put up these numbers as an organization for a week. There are producers going out and doing it single-handedly. Number two is Jeff Miller. Out of Arizona, I hope I got that right, 11,520 APV, getting beat out by someone who's not a stranger to our leaderboards and not festive over the holidays, is Elijah Carujo. Elijah Carujo, listen to this, guys, 15,800 APV. And I promise you that guy did not work 50 hours, 40 hours to make that happen. He's a very, he condenses his time frames. He's extremely efficient. He's also helping his family with their coffee shop, especially as they hit their 1 year anniversary of having that open, which congrats to you and your mom for having that. I think that that is so cool. During a COVID year, still managing not only your business and exploding, we got huge announcements coming next month also about that organization, and we're so fired up for them. So guys, keep an eye out, be rooting for. Thank you, Judd, for wearing the hat. I love that. Keep an eye out for the big things coming for this group. Let's go into apps, app count leaderboard, guys, because this is where it gets extremely ridiculous, right? So just in that top six, Amy Ostrom, DJ Robinson, and Rocco Pearson all tied for fourth with four apps for the week. Scott Emmer with five, Elijah Carujo with eight, and Jeff Miller, guys, not with just a normal double figure app count. He put out 20 apps last week. He was on a mission and he went and he accomplished it. So we're going to be hearing from this guy here in just a second. Also, let's talk about new writers for the week. My good friend, Ben Williams. I love that. Yay, Ben. Brand new writer right before Christmas and more apps to come. He's out of North Carolina. And then also recruits for the week, guys. I don't think I have the STP numbers over 10, Tina. If you've got those handy somewhere, I know you can announce them as well. I know in our organization alone, we had us and Barry. We did, both of them did over 10. I know Barry's on a mission of doing 20 STPs every single week until basically the cows come home and they break out agency owner. Tina, do you have anybody else with over 10 STPs for the week?
I know Chris Cook did over 10 last week too.
Okay, awesome, guys. That's awesome. And I don't know if the chat is disabled. Let's see. The chat is not disabled. If you had over 10 STPs through the week, feel free to put that in there in the chat bar so that you can be recognized appropriately. Also, new recruits, guys, we're hiring like crazy. You know, I don't know if you guys saw when the semis were being handed out that this is the biggest base shop, this biggest recruiting base shop on top of just the APV alone. We had some massive recruits coming in right before the holidays. Barry Davis, Brian Hamby, Val Zarn, and Chris Cook, all with one new recruit last week. My very awesome husband, he put up two brand new recruits. And Dustin Hensley, the asking to record every single Zoom session guy, went out and he hired three new recruits last week. So high five to you, Dustin. I know that you're out there striving and running for exactly what you and your family want. And I'm just so excited to see you going and taking ownership of that. So three new recruits for Dustin Hensley. I think we've got Tina's tips coming up. Miss Tina, do you have any tips for us this week, especially as we head into the new year?
I do. I want to talk about first Cookmas. So tomorrow we are going to announce the winner for Cookmas for an accumulated days of Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and today. So anybody can win this Cookmas tomorrow. Be sure to go out and write today because that will be counted on tomorrow's winner. Then there's going to also be a winner on Wednesday for Tuesdays. And on Thursday, Christmas Eve, there will be a winner for Wednesday's activities. Chris will be announcing that on Thursday, Christmas Eve. So be sure to write some APV so you can win. We have three great prizes left.
I believe of those great prizes that we have left, we've got still one call with Casey. Still yes. Available. We have $100, I believe, in lead credit available, as well as some gift cards to go out to eat and treat your family.
That's exactly right.
Those are your three gifts that are left over. Awesome, awesome gifts. Just to yourself as far as an investment heading into the new year. I mean, imagine starting your new year with a one-on-one call with the CEOs of this company. I mean, what could you really take from that? What kind of questions, what kind of wisdom could you pull out of a situation and a gift like that? So let's go kick some tail on heading into this new year. I love that. Thank you, Tina. Also, I want to make sure that we all are focused on the prize. The prize right now is the fact that this organization is top three in the entire company of having the largest percentage growth quarter over quarter from third quarter to fourth quarter in the entire company. We are number three, guys, which means if we all accomplish the goals that we have for ourselves just for the next 3 days, we are going to knock out the top two. So let's stay focused on what we're trying to accomplish. Go out there. I love what Elijah had put in GroupMe about how to focus and drive your business for the new year. So be sure to make sure that you are managing your calendar, managing your schedule efficiently, running your Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, so you can spend that Thursday, Friday with your family without feeling any off time from your business. So I'm excited about introducing our guest speaker of the day. The guest speaker of the last Master Agency Call of the Year is our good buddy, Jeff Miller out of Arizona. What I'm so excited about hearing from you, my friend, I believe you can unmute yourself. Can we hear you okay?
Can you guys hear me okay?
Yes, awesome. Jeff, tell us a little bit about who you are and what your organization looks like. What you got going on?
You bet. Jeff Miller from Phoenix, or actually Gilbert, Arizona. I'm direct to the great Joe Martinez. Been with Symmetry for just over a year now, and went full-time with Symmetry July 1st of this year.
Awesome. So you've got some big numbers. I saw your year-to-date numbers being posted, and you're still behind me, thank goodness. the guy has just been running half of a year, and he's been nuking me, and I'm running a full year. So I'm trying to pull up your year-to-date numbers here. Here we are. Jeff Miller, and this was on Saturday, so before this week that we're about to have, here sitting at $167,753 APV for the year. And you said, when did you become full-time?
July, just after the 4th of July weekend.
My gosh, that's impressive. So guys, there's a lot that's to be learned from this guy right here. And so if you could, I think we could all benefit from hearing about how you ran your week last week. Cause I mean, we're talking about just getting into the holidays, and I know a lot of us, we might have the mindset that people are taking time off or don't want to be purchasing insurance or wanting to wait until after the holidays are over. So tell us about your week last week. What kind of days did you run? What kind of schedule did you run? Your lead investment last week? So we can all take a little bit from this as we run into this week.
Yeah, you bet. I always start out my week on Saturday. I'll try to book five appointments for Monday on Saturday. And then during the week, I usually call Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday from 9 till noon, or until I have my calendar booked for those days. So my personal goal is to get as close to 25 appointments booked for the week as possible.
Wow. And how did you do?
I think I did 20 last week that I actually booked.
That's awesome. And how many did you sit with last week?
I believe it was 14.
Ooh, that is a good week. So I'm trying to figure out, Jeff, the math doesn't seem to add up here. If you put up 20 apps and you sat with 14 families, how in the world did you do that?
Well, a couple of things. One of the things that we've been talking about to make sure I'm profitable is making sure if somebody gets declined, that I go back and get with them and make sure we get them approved. And I've had some that have been declined. I do pretty good. Most of mine get approved. But so just going back to those people I've worked with to help them to make sure they actually have a policy in place to protect their family. So going back to them and also, writing multiple policies on an individual. You can write a regular policy and then an accidental death for so little to get them additional coverage that, they're really thankful they can get more coverage for just $10 or $15 a month. So just writing multiple policies, the more policies you write on a person, the more likelihood they're going to stay for a long time.
That is so good. That's awesome. And you've got a pretty, you've got an up and growing organization right now, don't you? Don't you have some new people coming out?
I do have some great new people coming on. I got Troy Stevens. He's been dialing and he's doing great, setting appointments, ran one. He's got a couple apps. I believe he's going to submit today.
There you go.
Yeah. First app. So excited about that. And I got a bunch of new people that just got through licensing and onboarded. So I've got between last week and this week, probably 5 new agents that are licensed and ready to go. So pretty exciting.
That's awesome. So not only do you have an organization that sounds like pretty close to a key leader organization coming out, you went out, you put up 11,000, almost 12,000 APV last week with 20 applications, which I promise you is going to get you top in the company when they announce that on the, I don't think we actually have a call this Wednesday. Oh my gosh. So I know once the graphics come out, you keep an eye out for that, guys. You'll be cheering Jeff on. Really, Jeff, if you could give anybody on here just maybe two words of advice about what you applied to your week last week that they could apply to their week this week to get similar results. What would you say is the two different things that you did this week, last week, to accomplish that compared to an average week for yourself?
Just be a consistency is one. It builds up if you just keep doing what you're supposed to, that consistency. And the second one was just, it's more than one word, but never give up.
That's awesome. Never give up. Sounds like you set a goal, my friend. You ran at it. You didn't give up. And when you put consistency in your business, I want to dive just a quick second into that. When you say consistency, what areas of your business are you remaining consistent? Is it just the in-home process? Is it with your schedule? Where do you find consistency is most important?
My personal, it would be my goals of setting my 25 appointments a week.
Staying consistent, not changing the goal, you know what I mean? Changing the process to get there and staying consistent and never giving up. Thank you, Jeff. I appreciate that so much for your time. This has been so good. Thank you for all of that. Guys, if you have any questions for Jeff, feel free to pass them to your upline. We'd be more than happy to get you some time and get those questions answered. I know that we do have a 12 o'clock call coming up today, guys. It is also going to be the last national call for the year that we have. So be sure to be plugged into that. I just want to go ahead and express my thanks. Definitely pass on thanks from Chris to you guys for such a wonderful year. We're really excited for this new year that we have coming up, considering that we have all these new implementations, the social media, which, guys, if you haven't plugged into that yet, go on Facebook, go on Instagram. go ahead and like Cook Financial Group, SFG. That's where you're going to be able to have free promotion stuff, guys, where you can promote your business, promote those who are doing great, especially if you're out there and you're striving for it and you're hitting leaderboards like Elijah and like Jeff, like Laura, and you want that on your page. You want people knowing that you're doing well. They just don't let them hear it from you. Let them see it. So what I'm really excited about is the fact that, you know, we've got all these new implementations. I can tell that it's making a difference in a lot of new people's lives. And we're just really excited about carrying our this momentum into the new year. So guys, y'all have a great week. Enjoy Christmas. Get the work done. Don't take the time off until you've got the work done. Stay consistent. And I hope we're all hitting our goals. Let's be the top group of the year of growth quarter over quarter. Merry Christmas, guys. Happy New Year. It's been so good. Hope you have a good one.